Hi, this is Abby from Just a Girl on Her Blog, and today we are going to be talking about making pretty labels in Microsoft Word. If you have spent much time on my blog, you know that I love to label everything. I love it when things are organized, and labels help me do that a lot better, and it's even better if they're pretty. So by the end of this tutorial, you are going to be able to make your own pretty labels using Microsoft Word. So the first thing we're going to do is open up our Word document, and in the Home tab here, you're going to go over to the Shape tab. Now I am on a MacBook Pro, so if you are using a PC or you have a different version of Word than I do, your buttons might be in a slightly different place, but they're all still there. So you might have to look around a little bit, but you should be able to find all the things that I'm referring to in the tutorial today. So I go to shape, and we'll start with a basic circle, pick the circle shape. And if I want to make a perfect circle, one little trick that I like to do is I just hold down the shift key while I click and drag, and that'll make a perfect circle for me, just like that. Now I can go into my format tab and play around with the height. So I want it to stay perfect. I'll lock the aspect ratio there. And let's just make it 3.5 inches. By 3.5 inches. One thing I always do with my shapes is I go into wrap text and I will choose in front of text. This just makes sure it's above everything else. So sometimes weird things happen and shapes will like go flying around the page. But if you have it on in front of text, that doesn't happen. So the other thing I do is Word, my version of Word automatically puts a little drop shadow on all of my shapes, and I don't really like that, so I take it off. I go into Effects, Shadow, and choose No Shadow. So we have our flat image. Then we can choose the fill color and the outline color of our shape. So we'll start with the outline, go to Line, and we'll click in here. And we'll just choose this bright pink color that's already on. Now you can see it, but it's not very thick. So in order to thicken it up, we'll go back under the line and go to weight. And you can choose any weight you like. I'm gonna go with 3 point. And then it just is defined a little better. So then for my fill for this shape, instead of the blue, I'm just going to go with a crisp, clean white. Choose white. And so now I have my outline circle. To make it a little more interesting, I like to add a second layer here. So I'll go back over to my shapes. I will pick another circle. Again, holding down the shift key, I'll click and drag and let it go. And pop over to my format tab again. Now I want this one to be a little smaller than my other one. So if my other one was 3.5 inches, we'll make this one 3.25 inches. That makes it smaller. Now in order to line it up with my other circle, I'm going to hold down the command key, or it would be the control key on a PC, and this first layer is already selected. As I hold down my command key, I'll click the second layer so that they are both selected at the same time. And then I can go up here to my align tool and click align center and then align middle, and then they're perfectly lined up. So easy. Going to my top circle that I just created, we'll choose wrap text and we'll pick in front of text again. We will also take the shadow off again. And then this one will also give a white fill. And for our line, we will make it bright orange this time. And again, we'll thicken it up so it's a little more defined. We'll choose 3. Now maybe instead of a solid circle on the inside, we want it to do something a little more interesting with it. So if you go under line and go down to dashed, you have all these different options. You can make little circles or a dashed line or dashes and dots, whatever you think looks good. We'll do dashes and dots here, and it just gives it a little different effect. Now we just need to add our words. So we'll go up to text box, click that, drag. drag a text box in here. And let's say this particular label is going in our pantry. So we'll say it's for sugar. And that's really small. So we'll go up here and we'll change our fonts. I know a font that I like is called Clicker Script. We'll make it a little bigger. Even bigger than that. We'll go up to 48. And then we'll make it a color. We'll go with, an aqua here. That's looking pretty cute. We'll drag our text box to the size we need it. And again, we'll do that same little trick that we did before to select everything. Push the command key on a Mac or the control key on a PC and select all three layers. Go over to Format and click Align Center and then Align Middle. And they're all lined up for you. And while you're over in this toolbar and you have them all selected, it's a good time to group them together. So if you go under this little icon here, you can group them. And now they're all one piece that you can move around the page, and you don't have to worry about moving the individual parts. So that was quick. You just made your first label. Super easy. And you can make them in all sorts of shapes and colors. And you can label everything in your house like I do, and it's great. So now we're going to learn a couple other tricks. We'll make a second label. We'll go into our shape tool again. And this time we'll go under basic shapes and we'll choose this plaque tool right here. And we'll draw it out. And this time we'll make it about 2.5 inches high and 4.5 inches wide. That'll give us a nice size label. We'll go to wrap text and choose in front of text. And under effects, we'll turn off the shadow, choose no shadow. And then for the fill this time, instead of doing a solid color or a white, let's go down into fill effects. And if you go under picture or texture, can choose a picture from a file. You can choose any picture on your computer that you want to put in there. So it could be a picture of your kids. It could be a pattern of some sort. I have a chalkboard background here that I'm going to use. Now you can see my chalkboard has filled my shape here. And I'm going to choose no line for this one. So it's already pretty well defined. And now I want to add my second layer. So we'll go back into shapes. We are going to choose that plaque shape again, and we'll draw it out. And we'll go into the formatting. We'll choose in front of text. We will turn off that little shadow again. And then we'll decide our height. So we will just go slightly smaller than the other one. We'll go at about 2.25 by 4.25 inches wide. And now let's line them up. Hold down the command key. Make sure both are selected. And then align center and align middle. And they're all lined up for you. And now we can format this inside shape here. So for a fill, since we want to see our chalkboard background, we will choose no fill. For the line, we will make it white. And then to beef it up a little bit, we will go into weights. And this time, instead of just choosing a solid line, we'll go down here and we'll choose this 3-point double line. Just looks a little bit fancier and gives our label a nice effect. And then we will just need to add words to this one as well. So if we click our text box, we can drag a text box in here. And let's say this one is going in our craft room. So we will say it's for ribbon. And we can't see it because it's black. So we'll go up here under our font color and we'll change that to white. We can center it up here as well, and we'll choose a font. Let's see, I like one called Snell Round Hand. and we'll make it a lot bigger, maybe 48. That looks good to me. And then we just need to line them up. So I will hold down the command key and push all three of my layers. Make sure I get them all selected. Go under format and align center and align middle. And while I have them all selected, I can pop up here and group them. So it's just one shape and I can move it all around together. And we're done. We have two different labels, two different styles. You can mix and match and play with them in a million different ways to create all sorts of different labels to help you get organized around the house or just add a pretty little touch to any area that you want to. So I hope this tutorial was helpful and thank you for watching.